true stories that were made into movies. Hey everyone, it's Lexa, and welcome back to another video. Lately, all you see in theaters are reboots, remakes, sequels, and prequels. Now and then you do see the occasional biographical drama pop up. If there's one thing people love more than a blockbuster, it is a blockbuster that is based, however loosely, on real events. Before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. The social network. Facebook has become a significant influence on how people interact and take in information, and it's strange to remember that it started with a few college kids. The Social Network, directed by David Fincher, follows the story of how this social media giant came to be. The film is set in the early 2000s on the grounds of Harvard University. In the film, Mark Zuckerberg is played by Jesse Eisenberg, while his best friend, Eduardo Saverin, is played by Andrew Garfield. The Facebook is created by both Zuckerberg and Saverin, and was built off of Zuckerberg's original website, FaceMash, where students rated each other based on appearances. After Facebook launched, Harvard seniors Tyler and Cameron Winklevoss and Divya Narendra accused Zuckerberg of stealing their ideas to create a competing social media product. Eventually, Zuckerberg kicks Saverin out of Facebook, leaving him to file a lawsuit against Zuckerberg. Oh, and Napster founder Sean Parker is somehow in the mix as well. Hidden Figures. Hidden Figures was released in 2016. It tells the widely unknown story about the minds behind one of the greatest space operations in history. The general public is often never educated about the contributions of NASA employees Katherine Johnson, Mary Jackson, and Dorothy Vaughan. Johnson, played by Taraji P. Henson, is a mathematician who calculated the orbital mechanics that were vital in achieving the first U.S. human crewed flight in space. She's now 100 years old. Jackson was an aerospace engineer and mathematician who was hailed as a human computer. Vaughan was a mathematician who worked as a computer programmer and made significant contributions to the U.S. All three of these women had to deal with a society that looked down on African American people and females, yet were able to achieve more than most people can imagine. Goodfellas. Goodfellas is an American classic, directed by Martin Scorsese and released in 1990. The film is centered on the now infamous Henry Hill, a criminal associated with the Lucchese crime family. Hill worked for them between 1955 and 1980. Goodfellas is an adaptation of the nonfiction book Wise Guy by Nicholas Pileggi and is about the rise and fall of Hill, his friends, and family in the mob world. Hill, played by Ray Liotta, was born in 1943. He was part of many crime incidents, including the Air France robbery in 1967, where Hill stole what would now be worth $3.1 million in the Lufthansa heist at the JFK airport, resulting in what's now a $22.6 million loss for the German airline. Aaron Brockovich. Legal clerk and environmental activist Aaron Brockovich had very little formal law education and still somehow managed to build a case against PG&E in 1993. In 1996, the case was settled for $333 million, with $133 million going to the law firm Brockovich worked for, Masri & Vitito. Brockovich earned a bonus of $2.5 million because of the case. All of that without any law degree. Julia Roberts portrayed the law clerk in the 2000 film Aaron Brockovich, directed by Steven Soderbergh. Wolf of Wall Street. If you've watched The Wolf of Wall Street, then you probably were shocked to learn that it is based off of a true story. Jordan Belfort is a former stockbroker. Wolf of Wall Street chronicled Belfort's career as a stockbroker in New York City when he used to work for the firm Stratton Oakmont. Since the events that took place in the movie, he went on to become a motivational speaker and author. The film features Leonardo DiCaprio as Belfort and Margot Robbie as his second wife, Naomi LaPaglia. Walk the Line. Johnny Cash was one of the most influential singer-songwriters of all time. He was one of the best-selling music artists of all time, too, selling over 90 million records. Walk the Line takes its title from one of Cash's hits, I Walk the Line. In the movie, Joaquin Phoenix portrays the late Cash with Reese Witherspoon as his wife, June Carter. The story follows Cash's ascent to fame, as well as his struggles with the guilt of his brother's death, substance abuse, and more. Carter and her family enter his life, which ultimately changes his destiny forever. Seabiscuit. Seabiscuit was a champion thoroughbred horse who became a household name after winning multiple races during the 1940s in America. What was so remarkable about Seabiscuit's victory was that he was a relatively small horse, only standing at a height of 5'2". His owners were Charles S. Howard, played by Jeff Bridges, Tom Smith, played by Chris Cooper, and Red Pollard, played by Toby Maguire. In total, Seabiscuit won 33 races in his lifetime. Gorillas in the Mist. Not many people remember a little film called Gorillas in the Mist. Sigourney Weaver portrays conservationist Deanne Fossey. Fossey studied gorilla groups in the mountain forests of Rwanda from 1966 to 1985. She heavily advocated for the protection of gorillas from poaching. Gorillas in the Mist was a 1998 drama based on Fossey's autobiography. The book is about Fossey's scientific study held at the Karasoke Research Center located in Volcanoes National Park. Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln served as the 16th President of the United States from 1861 until his assassination in 1865. Lincoln led America through its bloodiest war on home soil, the American Civil War. He was an imposing figure, standing at a height of 6'4". The film, titled Lincoln, was directed by Steven Spielberg with Daniel Day-Lewis as the former president. The movie takes place in 1865, near the end of the Civil War. The rest of the narrative focuses on the proposal of the 13th Amendment, which meant the abolition of slavery and involuntary servitude. The Lincoln movie ends with the assassination and a flashback of Lincoln's second inaugural address. Catch Me If You Can. Another film with the illustrious Leonardo DiCaprio at the forefront. Steven Spielberg directed and produced the 2002 film Catch Me If You Can. It is the biographical account of con artist Frank Abagnale during the 1960s. Abagnale was only 18 years old when he successfully pulled off a con job of posing as a Pan American World Airways pilot. He ended up stealing millions of dollars. In his later years, Abagnale went on to pose as a teaching assistant at BYU, a physician, and finally an attorney until his capture in 1969. Balto. Balto was an animated film based on the Siberian Husky who led his sled team in the final leg of the 1925 run to Nome. They carried precious cargo to the Alaskan town, the sled holding doses of diphtheria antitoxin to aid in the disease outbreak. During the run, Balto saves his team from being wiped out by the Toplol River and led them through the whiteout conditions of the trail. In the film, Balto is discriminated against by humans and dogs alike for his half-wolf lineage. In real life, Balto was 100% Siberian Husky, as far as anyone knew. That year, New York City unveiled a statue dedicated to Balto. It remains in Central Park. The Conjuring. The Conjuring is the first installment of the Conjuring Universe franchise. Released in 2013 and directed by James Wan, the movie follows paranormal investigators Ed and Lorraine Warren on one of their famous cases. Vera Farmiga and Patrick Wilson play the married couple. The Conjuring follows the Warrens as they travel to Rhode Island in 1971 to investigate a haunting. Ed Warren was a World War II veteran who then chose a career as a police officer. His wife Lorraine was a light trance medium and a self-proclaimed clairvoyant. During their career, they investigated over 10,000 cases. Ed passed away in 2006, though Lorraine lived until 2019 and recently passed in April. Apollo 13. Tom Hanks leads the way into space and back in this 1995 film directed by Ron Howard. Hank plays Jim Lovell, the commander of the Apollo 13 mission to land on the moon. It was the seventh manned mission of the Apollo space program and was the third intended to land on the moon. The crew needed to abort their moon landing after an oxygen tank exploded 2 days after launch. A shortage of drinking water, loss of cabin heat in the freezing conditions of outer space, and limited power were all obstacles the crew had to deal with while trying to make it back to Earth safely. 6 days after launch, they finally did just that. 127 Hours. Danny Boyle's survival drama, 127 Hours, stars James Franco as Aaron Ralston. Ralston is a mountaineer who took a near-fatal hike in Utah's Canyonlands National Park in 2003. During his hike, he slipped and fell into a slot canyon in Blue John Canyon. The fall caused him to crush his right hand and wrist that were stuck between a rock and a wall. Eventually, Ralston has to take some drastic maneuvers so he can escape. If you've seen it, you know what we're talking about. The movie is titled 127 Hours because that is how long Ralston was trapped in the canyon alone. Before we reveal number one, we've got a question for you. What is one fictional movie that you wish actually happened? Would you be happy if Star Wars was real, or if the Avengers existed in the real world? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. 1. Argo. Ben Affleck directed and starred in the 2012 historical drama entitled Argo. Affleck plays Mendez, who successfully created a phony production company with a real film producer, Lester Siegel, to save hostages taken in by terrorists in Iran. The two concocted a plan that involved the creation of a fake Star Wars-like movie. Mendez posed as a producer for the film. he entered Iran by the name of Kevin Harkins, meeting 6 escapees. Spoiler alert, they all make it out alive. The mission was kept a secret from the world for years. When Mendez received a medal for his courage and intelligence, he did so in secret, and then had to return the medal.